Alrighty, and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, once more to the Overwatch Open. Here in the round of 16, Team Liquid versus OneShot. We'll be heading into Lijiang for our second map. And Joshy, we just saw a very dominant performance coming out of Liquid just now on Dorado.
Yeah, full hold on the first stop, 77 meters, which you may be asking, I don't know how much that is. Yeah. But not even the first point, basically. They didn't allow any ground for OneShot, and OneShot, when the script was flipped and they had to defend, it took no time at all for Liquid to just run right through them. Kefri with that huge Death Blossom being kind of a standout performer there. One ult can change everything so fast. There's so many like instant kills basically in this game that it can a game can turn very quickly.
Yeah, and Kefri basically replacing Dummy for all intents and purposes. Had a good showing there. Definitely had some good Reaper plays towards the end. Was, of course, supported by the rest of the Liquid squad. But Liquid, I thought, looked stronger there than they have in the last week and a half, where they've been a little bit sketchy on things. Whereas, conversely, OneShot, I felt, looked a little bit weaker than we've seen them in recent times. As noted, they do have variability to performance. But to win against Team Liquid, especially if they're playing the way they are right now, OneShot is going to have to dig deep and find a different level than we saw here in Dorado. Because if they come out on Lijiang like they did in Dorado, I think this is going to be over in two.
Yeah. Well, Lijiang Tower, obviously very different play style. Could suit them more or could be worse for them, but we'll find out pretty soon here when we do get into the map. But yeah, King of the Hill, again, is just best 3 out of 5 rounds. It's, you know, symmetrical spawn, so there's no attacker's edge or defender's edge, anything like that. We've seen a number of mirrors, actually, coming out on King of the Hills recently. Usually the only difference is maybe a tank, a D.Va instead of a Winston, something like that.
Yeah, the other difference we've seen from time to time is every now and then you might see a Tracer instead of a McCree. Sometimes you get both at the same time, but Tracer seems to be a hot topic for the top teams right now. Do you run it? Do you not? I think we'll probably see at least one team run it here, but wouldn't be surprised if we didn't.
Yeah. Seen double McCree a couple of times. Here we're just flying through the maps, checking out the different points. We don't know which point is going to be up first until we actually see the players and those doors open, but right now, I think that Genji, obviously, Ultima Web, is going to be the choice. Look at this, Kefri on Anna. That's going to stay, right, as these doors open?
It is the fake out. Teams love doing that, where they know that the casters love Anna and like the idea of her being played, so they just tease us until the very end.
Yeah, I wouldn't expect Kefri as a non-support player to be playing Anna, but I've seen a lot of DPS players warm up with Anna and do pretty darn well, so I would not be surprised to see it eventually in a tournament.
Well, we are getting into right now, both teams trading off. First kill did go to the one shot, but AZK takes out Ultima Weapon back. Both teams suffering some losses here early on. Chronic is able to take out Mezzar, but the DPS for Liquid still up and alive. Raz going the counter onto Kefri, so it's very back and forth right now. No team with a huge edge. I'd say one shot actually with a very slight advantage here, but if AZK goes off, that can end. Does fan the hammer around the Psycho, takes him out. Looking now for Raz, takes out Raz, gets the double kill he was looking for, and Team Liquid now far more likely to take this point.
Look at that, and just a two-shot there on Genji to finish things off. Ridiculous stuff there from AZK. That is what the fans have come to expect from him on his McCree, but definitely some sharpshooting already in this point. 7% now for Liquid. That's going to continue to rise as OneShot needs to regroup. They've got a Transcendence available already. Psycho Waffle will actually soon have a Sound Barrier, and Ultima Web soon with that Dragon Blade could turn things pretty quickly here.
The Dragon Blade is definitely a big ultimate that there's not a huge equivalent from of the Liquid side based on what they're at. I mean, Death Blossom is kind of like that, but I feel like there's times where Dragon Blade opens up even more so. Either way, the offense one shot is moving forward. They have not used Sound Barrier just yet, but the Dragon Blade is on the way. Ultimate Weapon has no HP, does get the Sound Barrier on him, but Mezzar, not even caring, gets in the backline, gets a cleave he's looking for. Already a double kill here for Liquid. Moving it forward, and ID again get the cleanup, and that is going to be another hold for Liquid here on the Garden.
Yeah, Tank's actually getting most of the killing blows, but AZK, we can tell, just laying into pretty much anything he can look at and take shots at. So very well done there by Liquid to withstand those couple of ultimates. There was good timing for Minstrel actually popping Sound Barrier the moment that Psycho Waffle did. So everything working out for Liquid so far. Now we've got Graviton Surge available on both sides. So this could be a very big engagement coming up. Transcendence also available. There's the first Graviton Surge and the Transcendence catching tons of players. Death Blossom could come in here, but there's already 3 deaths on the side of one shot. So no need for that Death Blossom.
AZK got the triple kill Deadeye, gave his life for it, but that, in the words of many in other games, is just worth. So really good stuff coming out from AZK, the combo onto the ID there. And I think ID was going for the spot where you can throw the Graviton and actually throw people into the pit. Didn't quite get it, but that is a danger going into Azaria here on Legion.
And Kefri still has Death Blossom available, so that's perfect for Liquid as Graviton Surge comes out on the side of one shot. Death Blossom is still going to go in there. Rassi now with the Death Blossom trying to get some kills. Doesn't actually come up with anything. Chronic actually looks like he took an environmental kill. Not sure what happened to that, but the Winston ult definitely tells the story. I'm sure he just got knocked off. Caffrey trying to find this Lucio now. Psycho Waffle doing a good job skating along the top and staying out of view. Rassi and Psycho Waffle and Ultima Lab all going down to the eventual Death Blossom. Good stuff from Caffrey.
And this is the case here. Liquid. Liquid just burned all their ultimates at the end. They don't have to worry about an extra engagement. It's at 99%. It's all one shot can do to keep this in order time. We do have the Tracer getting to the point at the very last moment, but it's not going to be enough. XE sacrifices his body for nothing, and that is going to be a pretty firm round one to Liquid. One shot not really able to turn much in their favor there.
Yeah, 100% to 0% does not feel good, especially after that shutdown on Dorado. So one shot may need to just change things up entirely or just try harder, do better, get some kills. AZK is a huge factor there in that round, though, just hitting so many shots from inside the very safe point while his tanks basically, you know, ran protection for him.
Right, and that's the case here where one shot did put AZK under more pressure than, say, the other Caleb Hill match we watched earlier in the day. But I do think that pressuring AZK is definitely one of the paths to victory here against Liquid. I mean, really any team right now in King of the Hill, if you can get pressure on the McCree and take him out, it's huge, because if McCree is still alive as two, three people are dead, it's very easy for him to pick off the remnants, especially if there's no shield to save him. Mm-hmm.
And Flash and Fan still comes into play. Fan the Hammer now is like a submachine gun, basically. So if you've got, you know, under 200 health, it's possible that you'll be just erased.
All right, well, the offense right now moving in. Risking the boop right now by going from that side, though. Not going to be too much. Liquid getting the first kill on to Ultima Weapon. XE countering here. XE on the double kill right now. I think he's quite charged up on Zarya, looking for a little more. 4v4 here on the point. Liquid, though, starting to get the kills. They need to turn this back. It's very even, but still with a minor Liquid tilt thus far.
Yeah, the damage dealers both still standing for Liquid is actually great for them, ID, and actually only running Zarya and Winston together. Kefri and Mistral actually get taken out by Rassi, so that's actually the best pickup that One Shot's had yet in this King of the Hill map. Now taking out the Hang as well, so finally they do manage to take the point and start that percentage going up in their favor.
Well, Razgo and the Tracer clearly has been a better choice here thus far. He's definitely getting a lot done. Throws a pulse bomb in the back, was looking for the Winston pick, did not get it. Mezrar takes out Ultima Weapon, though, pretty early on in this fight. Trade for DPS as AZK went down, so both teams down at DPS. Liquid's still going to look to pressure this, and a lot now on Raz. If Raz is able to get to the back and keep up this Tracer pressure, get this pick out the Winston, which he gained close to, but no, not going to happen. Kefri comes in, picks up the double kill, and Liquid now the big opportunity to turn this right back, Josh.
Yeah, he's looking for the follow-up on Chronic as well. That ult's going to end eventually, and he's just going to die to that combination of AZK, ID, and Kefri. Everything looking good for Liquid now as they flip the point. 33% for one shot, pretty admirable compared to the last point, but we'll see if they're going to have any opportunity to try and flip things back. ID with that Graviton Surge, trying to stay alive, does kill Ultima Web during the Dragon Blade. That's a huge pickup, denying that ultimate. Graviton Surge could come out, and it does, catches several members. Oh, three members just getting nuked down.
That was a double Graviton going on here. Liquid, though, coming out of the victor. AZK with the double kill cleanup towards the end. And yeah, everyone was going for the Tobelstein, as it were, double Graviton out. So unfortunately for One Shot, did not work out in their favor. And now for them going forward, they still have about maybe five pushes left, but they have to be careful how they use ultimates. They do have one trick in their bag here. They are going up against Death Blossom, but they have Sound Barrier. So I think even ult-wise, I would give them a slight advantage going in here if they use a Sound Barrier engage right.
It's possible, but the follow-up has to be there. How are they going to deal the damage? So far, Genji and Tracer just haven't been enough compared to this Reaper and McCree combo, but Kefri does get out of there with only 9 health, grabs the full heal, and is able to escape. Ultima Web and Zarya both trying to combine here do actually get the kill on Kefri eventually. Nice deflect there as the Dragon Blade comes out. Ultima Web looking for some squishy targets, only sees tanks in front of him. That's okay, though. He's going to dive, but Zarya does get the kill on ID. AZK just walks into it, unfortunately for him, and Minstrel goes down as well, so One Shot has a chance to flip the point once again.
And that right there is the power of Sound Barrier in King of the Hill. If one team has it and the other team doesn't, it is so incredibly hard to actually deal again. You mentioned there that I didn't have the DPS ult to go with it. You don't even need the DPS ult. You just speed boost in, Reaper, W mouse ones forward, and it can be really effective. Kefri got cut out early, did not work out. Next fight, though, here underway, Kefri does have Death Blossom at the right. Minstrel soon have a Sound Barrier of his own. So if they can pick off one person here and Sound Barrier for the rest of it, it's going to be huge. Chronic goes down early, a 65 for Liquid, and Sound Barrier on the menu. Liquid is well positioned to take this point back.
Can they do it? AZK finds a couple early shots, but then gets focused down very quickly. The Graviton Surge, of course, helping out there. The Sound Barrier was just a hair late to save AZK's life. Minstrel goes down to Hang, already down. Kefri having to Wraithwalk just to continue to contest, but One Shot looks like they will be able to clean up here. Ultima Muwep actually moving forward now toward the enemy spawn to try and keep that McCree and potentially this Zarya from getting into position.
Well, if there was a mistake there, was that Minstrel just waited too long for the sound barrier. He could have saved AZK's life and mitigated way more of that Graviton. It was too late. And as a result, One Shot is well positioned here. Maybe take this round. Ultra Weapon has Dragon Blade up and ready. Can run right in. Graviton comes out, gets absolutely no one. Graviton from ID, not hitting pay dirt. Ultra Weapon gets that backline, takes out AZK and ID. Still though, One Shot, no, this is really good for them. It looks like they are going to hold up, barring some real heroics here from Liquid.
Yeah, Mezzer with this ultimate available as well, going to try to knock people off the side. Looks like he got one right away. Psycho Waffle, the healer, getting knocked off. Zarya just went flying, but it looks like she actually landed on the ledge. Ults coming out basically from every direction at this point, but One Shot still hanging on. Really, five members available against only two now from Liquid, and the Wraithwalk ends. He's going to get nuked down immediately to hang as the soft squishy's in, not even going to make it to the point.
All right, so One Shot finding their footing there. Raz and the Tracer really being the difference. I feel like he wasn't having the best game on McCree before, but he was enough of a distraction Tracer that opened things up. Definitely gave Ultima Weapon some good opportunities there. And I will say this, though, I think that that's a different fight if Minstrel hits the sound barrier just a little bit earlier. I think Liquid probably would have won that fight if AZK stayed alive, and who knows if One Shot is able to take that round. But it's good One Shot to capitalize on mistakes like that, which every team can make from game to game.
Yeah, it's interesting. So obviously the incredibly huge difference between Tracer and McCree is that Tracer has an escape, and McCree, if he can take a couple shots but then immediately gets Graviton Surge or ultated by anyone, basically, he can just crumple, while Tracer at least has some options to try and save herself. So I think Rusty, yeah, moving off the McCree onto the Tracer, definitely suiting them here. And now we're on the control room of Lijiang Tower, getting that speed boost toward the point. Will they go around the left side? Yeah, I see this a lot. Just they kind of start on the higher ground sometimes, just to be able to loop all the way around and sneak up.
Well, right now, we do have Liquid here in this back room looking for the opportunity. One Shot just poking right back at them. Neither team being super, super aggro right now. They don't want to risk losing the first player and having the snowball against them. But Mwitz now being more aggro, does move in, drops a shield, gives room for Reaper, and as a result, Kefri able to take out Chronic. So 65 in favor of Liquid. They're able to get the kills they need to get. AZK right now doing all sorts of damage in the backfield. Ultimate Weapon will drop, and that is going to be first cap here to Liquid.
Yeah, AZK landing the shots as needed there, gets another assist onto Psycho Waffle. Now we've got One Shot having to regroup a bit. Rassi does have Pulse Bomb available, but it can be tough to land a really juicy Pulse Bomb without the Graviton Surge on King of the Hill. Everyone's just basically trying to stay away from Tracer as it is. And the Graviton Surge that whiffed on that last round, you could see four members of One Shot in the general area, so I can't blame ID at all for pulling the trigger there, but they were so aware that it was coming that they easily just scattered and hit no one, and that can be really rough for Azaria. Pulse Bomb not coming out just yet. Sometimes the Winston is the big enough target where you just tag it on there and hope you get the kill there, but going to continue just blinking around, getting the kill there on Dehang. Zenyatta missing from the fight. These orbs are missing and no possibility of Transcendence. There's One Shot using their Transcendence, trying to flip the point. Will they get the kills they need?
Well, the Dragonblade is out. Ultimate Weapon gets the double kill to finish it out. Looking for Zarya, still feasting. Takes out ID for the triple kill. Moves a little bit further, and Winston one of the last people up and alive here.
It's funny how often Dragonblade gets sated compared to Hanzo's dragon.
Yeah, I mean, I guess the dragon in sword form just a little bit more effective at eating.
Just guiding it, actually.
Exactly.
Like, being able to dash around with the dragon seems powerful. Hanzo could learn a thing or two.
Absolutely. Well, you look at the trailer, certainly Genji got the better of there. But either way, we're getting into the next fight. Transcendence already coming out here from Dehang, trying to buy Liquid a little bit of time. Here come the happy little skulls from AZK. Had a moment, did not take it just yet, didn't like what he saw.
He didn't like the deflect.
Yeah,
that he
the
saw.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And now Graviton Surge coming out here. Four kills from One Shot, following through a full team effort.
Very nice.
And One Shot going to hang on here. So Liquid now having some trouble. It's going to be 44% here in just a moment. And this is looking pretty decent for One Shot, especially if they can win the next fight.
I wonder if they were to swap someone around. It's not going to be Kefri, obviously, because he's got the Death Blossom available right now. But have we seen AZK hop on Tracer, like, ever? Or is it just all McCree all day?
I've seen him hop on Tracer before.
Okay,
so
nice.
I think if things really go bad in this round, we might see him swap up in the next. Either way, though, the fight is engaged right now. Raz is in the back looking for a Pulse Bomb target. Graviton Surge does come out here for Liquid. Sets up AZK to kill Ultimate Weapon. He goes down immediately, the Raz. So Raz firing right back. Both teams down to DPS, and for now, One Shot is doing a good job of delaying this. Even if they lose this fight, they've bought another 20% as it's taken place.
Kefri has to feel bad letting that Winston get away, but then finds the Zarya right after, so good stuff there. Now having a Zenyatta in your sights as a Reaper is usually a pretty good feeling, unless they get some teammates and their Ultimate Web shows up and helps take him out. Surprisingly, One Shot still in control of the point, and it seems to be a lot on Psycho Waffle's Lucio, actually, continuing to contest. AZK gets in there for a kill on Rassi, but does fall quickly to Ultimate Web. ID just trying to stay at 100 charge as long as possible and continue to melt people as they enter here. One Shot, it looks like they're reeling because they're so spread out, but they are actually still in control of that point at 93%.
This is good strategy right now from One Shot. I mean, it's unfortunate that they've lost control of the fight, but they're doing enough to get every last little bit percent. So if after they lose a point, which they do here, all they need, Joshy, is one more fight to win this round. So they have some time to really build up ults and go from there. ID, of course, has a Graviton. So does Xe. And we'll see if they fall through. Of course, Graviton into Pulse Bomb is a huge wombo combo, and we haven't seen too much of it yet. Maybe we'll see it in the next fight.
Rulf does have Transcendence available now, too. So One Shot may actually have just the ultimate edge coming into this next engagement. But where are they? Like, Kefri, there we are. The Graviton Surge actually comes out from Liquid first, and Reaper's just taking as many shots as he can. Rulf did pop that Transcendence to save as many lives as he could. And it looks like they're actually trading a bit here. Kefri trying to find some targets, has to get out of there. He's got Death Blossom available, but will he ever find the opportunity to use it? Ultimate Weapon with the Sound Barrier in tow, pops the Dragon Blade, finds two kills, three kills immediately, going for the fourth. ID goes down, One Shot firmly in control here. They're going to flip the point and take a second round on Lijiang.
Ultimate Weapon getting everything he wanted there. And yeah, this is now much more in favor of One Shot. They've come alive in a way that they really did not come alive back on Dorado. They came out very flat on Dorado, but now popping with life. And we'll see what goes on here for the next two rounds. Liquid, of course, has looked close in all this. So I would not be surprised to see Liquid come back and win the next two rounds. But either way, it's been a great Lijiang so far. Excited to see what comes here as we revisit the night market once more.
Yeah, and this is one that One Shot actually took this round the first time around as Rassi swapped onto that Tracer. So it feels good returning to the point that you won already, but then it feels worse if you do lose it. So we'll see now if their cohesion is going to actually maintain here. AZK still on that McCree, as you'd expect. Kefri still liking his chances with Reaper. Everything kind of staying the same there on Liquid side. One Shot still sticking with what's winning them some rounds.
All right, so yeah, I would not expect Raz to go back to the McCree right now. It's been working way too much. And we look at the positioning here. We see that One Shot goes for the point around the back. Liquid taking the courtyard. Both teams looking for that all-important first pick. Winston's diving into each other. Ezra actually at the back half a little bit, was a little bit exposed. Chronic eats a lot of poke and turn. Not a good day to be a scientist as a target number one for both teams, but either team falling here just yet, and they're being cautious about how they approach this.
Winston's head is enormous. It's so easy to shoot. So AZK taking full advantage of that fact, taking some free shots on Chronic. He knows he can always turn toward a tank and get some damage in. Rassi blinking around now as Tracer. Will have Pulse Bomb available. What will he find with it? It's tough to throw it onto that Reaper, of course, because Wraithwalk exists, but then the Sound Barrier also keeps everyone up, so well done by Liquid. No one has actually grabbed the point yet, and it is just now starting to flip in Liquid's favor.
Well, AZK has been unleashed here in this fight. He has three kills already. Nice. Make it a fourth, just dome Zenyatta towards the end of that. So AZK, again, putting Liquid on his back and more able to win them that fight towards the end. And first control is going in favor of Team Liquid.
All right, four ults available for One Shot. That is a lot of combo potential with both supports and the Graviton Surge and the Dragon Blade all available. Anything could happen here. Liquid on the other side only has that one defensive ultimate and the one Deadeye. So as everything starts to happen, you can see the Deadeye in the far back of the point. Not actually finding any kills. Does get some damage in on Chronic that leads to a kill. Dragon Blade versus McCree right now, though. Genji's going to come out on top. There's a nice Pulse Bomb there onto Minstrel. And Rassi and the Ultimate Web are cleaning up.
Rassi right now, triple kill. Got a good stick, followed through, took out to hang. Ultimate Weapon and Raz being the Bash Brothers of that fight for One Shot. They retake control of the point here, so they're going to get their first points on the board here in this round. Not the worst look coming out from them. And from Liquid, I mean, they started out well. We'll see if they can retake this in a moment. Note that either team will have Sound Barrier up for a while, so going to be just winning this on the nuts and bolts and maybe a Graviton.
That's actually good for One Shot here, just already being in control of the point. The less opportunity that they have to flip it, the better. To hang and Mezzer, getting some kills there onto Chronic and Rulf, their counterparts. Actually, the Zen and Winston killed the Zen and Winston. Looks like Rassi gets a kill on the Reaper, which is going to remove a lot of that DPS, especially with the tank and Zenyatta already gone. So One Shot looks like they're going to maintain control.
Yeah, One Shot, they're doing a good job. It was a bit of a scrappy fight. Both sides were trading out. In fact, Liquid is still here on the point, trying to make the most of it. Mezzar with the Zenyatta does have Harmony Orb. Raz not going to be able to do anything. Does get taken out by that Zenyatta. And Liquid is making some good space here. We'll see if it pays off. Ultimate Weapon now goes to the back, forces out the Transcendence. Kefri does have Death Blossom here at the ready. Might be looking for it in just a moment. Has Ultimate Weapon in his sights, just going for left click with those Hellfire Shotguns. Gets taken out! Maybe should have ulted earlier. I'm not sure, but Ultimate Weapon definitely do a good job of keeping One Shot in this, even though in that middle of the fight, they did lose control of the point.
He had to flee, though. 22 health, and in fact, still standing is actually kind of incredible because Winston was right there next to him, so he decided to duck out long enough to get this Dragon Blade. Mezzer with the assist there. Minstrel going down right into the two DPS of the other team. Can he actually find another kill? Deflect actually gets some damage in on ID there on Zarya. Rassi getting the killing blow, but everything looking good for One Shot again. They actually pass Team Liquid in percentage now.
Yeah, it's been a very close game here thus far, but One Shot, as you mentioned, things have been going very well for them in the last little bit. They will have Soundbear for the next fight, so Minstrel, that's going to cancel out if both teams play it right. So a lot to be said here for Kefra as he moves in. We'll have Death Blossom at the ready. We do have the Soundbears coming out from both sides. Every team equally dropping the beat. Graviton did come out of the main, and here comes Kefri. Death Blossom at the ready, takes out Psycho, gets Ultima with the aid of AZK, who is now also on a Tracer. That is three kills for Team Liquid, and Joshy, they're going to be taking this back and make this even closer.
I can't believe it. AZK was just so lethal with the McCree and still flips to Tracer, and it makes the difference. Just that mobility coming into play very heavily here, especially against a Tracer and a Genji. McCree feels a little immobile versus those two DPS, and right now Liquid is it's paying off having AZK do the switch here. No one else really has made any switches throughout this entire time except for Rassi doing the same exact switch.
Kefri right now opening up the bank, gets a double kill to start this out. XE on the Kefri takes him out, but not before the damage was done. Chronic in
going
the back.
Crazy.
The almost fighting game S combos of Primal Rage takes out to hang. And One Shot looking up pretty decent as they come back in here. Still very back and forth, of course, because Kefri got the suplex. Here comes a Graviton. Three people in on that Graviton. ID of the fall through. And Liquid now on the verge of evening this up. 2-2.
Absolutely brutal combo there. We do have the both DPS players actually for One Shot in there. Ultimate Web does go down though, and now Tracer is going to be an easy cleanup, and Liquid will take this to a round 5 on Lijiang Tower. That's going to be the open air environmental kill bridge fest, basically, once again. I forget the name of that one.
The Garden.
The Garden. So we will be going back to the Garden for that one, as well, Control Room was the third point.
The interesting thing about the Garden that we've seen a lot here lately that we have not seen yet here today is the Graviton Surge point from Zarya, where if she puts a Graviton at the right point on the bridge, she can dump everyone into the pit. It's hard to do, and teams definitely look out for it, but it's still amazing when it happens.
You know what's really funny? You hit the Graviton Surge in that spot that drops everyone, and then Reaper Wraith walks out of it expecting to live and just drop. That happened to me in Ranked. Recently, I hit a nice Graviton Surge and just watched him plummet before everyone else.
Well, you know, we need a hero that can just pull heroes to safety. And if you support, they just pull people out of those situations. But either way, we're getting right into it. Both teams crossing their respective bridges. They're going to fight it out here in the courtyard of Garden. Already going poke. Both Winstons leaping in right away. That's the role of Winston. Mezzar, though, getting a lot more done. Takes out Psycho in the beginning of the fight. Two kills, now three kills here for Liquid. And this is going to be a quick capture for them, Josh.
Definitely noted the AZK flash onto Ultima Web as he was stunned there, unable to move. Great positioning there for McCree to be able to get that close to a Genji and come away with the kill. AZK, it looks like calibrating maybe, just takes a shot at the floor. So he's going to move over to the side. Actually, already plants a couple of bullets into Ultima Web's face there. We'll see if Chronic and the rest of the One Shot crew can move around to the right side. Will they leap across? Yes, they will. Find that Reaper immediately. He's going to Wraith Walk out. Shield goes down, protecting everybody for about 600 extra health, but it goes away so fast. Chronic still looking for some squishy targets that he can zap down, but it looks like Liquid's still standing very firmly. Ultima Web actually died near the beginning of that engagement. Rassi and Chronic both down now. One Shot not looking great on this fifth round.
Generally speaking, if you lose someone like Ultima Weapon that early in the fight, which Team Liquid clearly did, it becomes that much harder to actually pull it back. Because you look at Liquid right now, or sorry, you look at One Shot right now, who else is going to do all sorts of damage to bring it back? That puts a lot of load on Raz. And for a Tracer, Tracer's better when the fight is degenerated a little bit, maybe someone's already low. If you Ultima Weapon dies early, it's going to be very hard for One Shot to take any of these fights, just because Tracer is his counterpart.
Yeah, you essentially need ultimates in that case for the solo DPS to make anything happen. But great deflect there from Ultima Web. Keeps him alive. Rassi actually looks like he ate an environmental kill. Not sure exactly what happened there. AZK lands the kill on Ultima Web. Soundbarrier did get used for Liquid, but they're at 56% and climbing. They'll be at 65 before you know it. And One Shot really running out of opportunities here. Even after they had that great resurgence in rounds 2 and 3, now letting it slip before our very eyes.
Garden Sage has not seemingly been super kind to them. We'll see if they can turn this around, but really they only have about 2 more pushes left here. They don't have a lot of ultimates in their name. ID still has a Graviton. He's going to be looking for that here in just a moment, so keep a close eye on ID as he looks for it. Both teams playing out here in the Garden. 2 quick kills come out from One Shot, and here comes the counter Graviton by ID. 4 people sucked in, but it does not matter. The sound barrier will keep everyone alive, and One Shot showing a little bit of life as they will get their first capture here on Garden.
Very nice. Comboed the ultimate, stayed alive through the Graviton Surge. We were waiting for ID to hit the button, and when he did, everything went okay for one shot. I don't know if they lost a single player there, but it looks great from their end, as they were about to lose the entire tournament, basically. That was their tournament life, only 14% away, so very glad for them to be able to reclaim that point, keep this thing going. Graviton Surge is at the ready for Exe. He sees everybody walking across to this hallway side. That's a great spot for a Graviton Surge, I gotta say.
Yeah, if he could get a huge Graviton, it would
be big. Oh my goodness, they're all there.
He's looking for it right now. Winston does leap to the back. He doesn't have the best look, but he does get three people in towards the end, but he gives his life up for it, dies to Kefri. Liquid, they know if they win this fight, they win the map and the series, so they are putting everything on the board here. Transcendence does come out, but it's going to be met here by the Sound Bearer. Kefri still doing work at the AZK, takes out Chronic. It's now a 6v4 in favor of Team Liquid. They smell blood in the water. ID going to get the cleanup. Ultimate Weapon with the Dragon Blade trying to pull it back. Probably not going to happen, though, as Psycho goes down. And this might be it. Liquid on the verge of knocking out one shot here today.
Oh man, who's going to be first back? Is it going to be Ultimate Weapon on that Genji? Just a simple dash across. He's waiting for his teammates. Of course, you don't want to just overcommit and get blown up immediately. He's waiting for his opening, and he does actually hop onto the point. Is it going to actually stretch that overtime, though? He needs to stand on it again. Actually, someone is in there, Chronic, dropping a Winston Shield. Does manage to actually get out with a kill. Exe and Ultimate Weapon get kills as well. AZK gets the kill on Lucio, so that's going to be tough without a Lucio trying to keep this overtime extended.
Yeah, this is the Hail Mary effort here from OneShot. It's very difficult to keep it in overtime nowadays. ID gets the cleanup, a very charged up Zarya on a triple kill. So ID showing just how lethal Zarya can be when charged up, and that is going to be it. Liquid, they were on the verge of losing that. They were down 2-1, and they brought it back right back. They won the last 2 rounds, and they eliminated OneShot here from the tournament. But at the very least, it does show the people at home that despite what happened to Toronto, OneShot is a team with talent potential. They just haven't put it all together yet. They still have a ways to go, and unfortunately for them, the good version of Team Liquid came out here today, and that was enough to fail them.
Yeah, Dorado could have gone much better for one shot, clearly, as they did get full held on the first point, but I think they should be okay with their performance there in the King of the Hill map, Lijiang. I think that maybe if Rassi started on Tracer, we'd have a different result. It's possible.
Yeah, I think you're right there. You mentioned that because Raz was on McCree and really didn't get a whole lot done. But once he went to the Tracer, it really opened things up to the point that AZK went on Tracer and won the maps they were losing. But McCree really, really good on the guard stage. You have much longer line of sight to poke things out. And that probably helped in the end, where I think you look at that, usually you do see teams go for the McCree or historically the 76 before everyone abandoned 76. So unfortunate for one shot, they will get eliminated, but we'll probably see them back next week.
Yeah, they get some points. I'm sure they'll be back next week. And back with us right now is Alex Machine. How are you doing?
That was a spicy segue.
Was
I'll give
it?
You that one. That was nice. Yeah, 10 out of 10. So basically you've hit all the nails on the head that I was planning on addressing. I think the first thing I wanted to raise was the fact that we saw some Tracer play, which I admittedly does pop up more in these game modes. But I mean, the discussion that you started having, Josh, was you were saying that AZK was doing so well with McCree and yet still made that decision to bring Tracer out just towards the end there, despite hitting everything with McCree. I mean, was that just a kind of leniency towards mobility? Was that because they wanted to get speed on the hill? Like, what was the reason to make a switch like that? Like, it's not like it, you seem to have an answer for it.
Well, it's a solid combo, right? You get the mobility and the escape, basically. So anytime AZK comes into the fight and only lands one or two shots before him being blown up, that's a possibility that Tracer could have survived that, continued to dish out damage. And when he pulled the Tracer out, they were down 1-2, so it was kind of the desperation tactic. I need to get to the point at least. I don't want to be on McCree walking back as we lose the third round.
ZP, you painted a picture for one shot as the gatekeepers of North America. You know, the lower teams can't beat them, the higher teams walk through them. I'd like you to find a silver lining for me in this 2-0 defeat.
I mean, the silver lining is that they came very close to taking Lijiang. They showed that they do have potential. It's a weird thing because they lost map one horribly, where it's just like, what are these guys even doing?
Yes.
And yet, Lijiang showed a lot of potential, saying, look, how we play in Dorado is not fully reflective of our skill. And the thing for OneShot is that they do have a portfolio of good game or good tournaments behind them where they have done really well. So I think they can fall back on that, but they still have to find that missing piece, whether it be recruiting one really awesome DPS player, the supplement Ultima weapon, or whatever it might be. But clearly they're not there just yet.
Okay.
But at the very least, they're hanging in there in the way that a lot of other teams aren't. So that is their silver lining there, is that it could be worse.
It certainly could be worse. And it looks pretty good as well for Liquid. That's our next discussion. We talked about it before. I mean, we made it abundantly clear here on the desk that we didn't know if two players were even playing.
Yes.
You know, like, that's testament to how new and fresh this roster is. And so, gents, you've got to see one best of three. We may very well see them more as they progress throughout the weekend. What are your opening thoughts on this new Liquid locked in six?
Well, Kefri certainly performed well.
Kefri looked great,
I had no complaints about Kefri's Reaper performance.
Widow?
He never got caught out. There was no Widow in this time around, yeah. I think Dorado, he performed well as Reaper. King of the Hill, he performed well as Reaper. So everything, I don't think you could ask more from Kefri if he's going to be their new guy.
We don't even know these guys.
Who knows?
These guys seem so temperamental. Anything to add to this?
The one thing to add that I think might be a little bit worrisome for Liquid moving into the future is that when they did really well, when they were really giving the top teams their best fights, that was back when Pharah was really, really good, and you saw ID on Pharah doing all that sort of work. And now he's on tanks, and he had a pretty good game. But I'm not sure if Kefri and AZK together are going to be contributing quite what ID was when Liquid was really bringing to other teams. AZK, though, did look really good today, better than I think I've seen him in the past. So if he can keep playing like that and up it a little bit more, I think the future could be very bright for Liquid with this roster.
It certainly could be. We're going to keep seeing teams rise and fall through the ranks here at the Overwatch Open. For now, we do take a break. When we do come back, we have another exciting game. You get to see Cloud9. What form are they in, fresh off of their, well, progress they made in the first week of the Overwatch Open? And I was about to tell you what the final game of the day was, but I guess I'll keep that secret. I'll pop it in my pocket. And I'll tell you that later on. For now, though, you have Cloud9 to look forward to, and we do come back. You get to see if those boys can do better than they did last week.